I will speak about the Russian Academy of Sciences and the Arctic, about the experience of the Kola Science Centre, about its past, present, and future. And we are located in Kola Peninsula inside the Arctic Circle, so we are working, we are living and working in the Arctic. And we are 200 kilometers from Murmansk to the south. This is somewhere in the middle of the Kola Peninsula. And the Kola Science Center was established in 1930 as a Hibini mountain station of the Russian, of the Soviet Academy of Sciences. And the main driver of this, the founder of the Kola Science Center was academician Fersman. And the idea was to establish a research base for the long-term observations in the Arctic and to provide strong links between science and the emerging, at the time, Soviet industry in the Russian North. During its history, Kola Science Center changed its name several times, and at the end of 2017, we received the status of a federal research center. So now we are federal research center, Kola Science Center of the Russian Academy of Sciences. And now we have three branches. We have seven institutes or divisions, and we have about 1,200 people, and among them 500 researchers, or as in Russian we say, scientific workers, научные работники. We have a research base in Barentsburg, in Svalbard Archipelago, and we are about 20% of our budget comes from collaboration with industry. We are not extremely rich, but also we are not extremely poor. And our mission is a scientific research and providing scientific and technological support for the sustainable development and safety of the Arctic zone of the Russian Federation. And I would like to emphasize that this is Kola Science Center is the only Russian academic center which is located above the Arctic Circle, so inside the Arctic Circle. And let me briefly tell you about some the institutes which we have within our center. So first, this is a geological institute. On the right side, you will see director of each institute. And the geological institute is dealing with geology of Kola Peninsula, geology of the Arctic, exploration of strategic mineral deposits, Arctic mineralogy, and even geological and mineralogical tourism. And I would just would like to emphasize that Arctic mineralogy is very special because, for example, in Kola Peninsula is actually the world champion in discovering of new mineral species. So more than 250 new mineral species were discovered in Kola Peninsula, so in the Arctic, and this is about 5% of all known mineral species. So, and this was not only work by Russian scientists; it was also it was many international teams were working on the Kola Peninsula. So, these minerals are really beautiful and interesting. We have mining institute, which is the purpose of which is to elaborate mining technologies for complex geological environments, such as we have in the Arctic. Geomechanics and safety of mining, underground construction technologies, and for example, I would like just to say these are two recent projects of them. This is engineering of underground sites for low power nuclear stations and radioactive waste disposal for the Arctic, and they also this is done with collaboration with state corporation, Russian state corporation Rosatom, and they also do a lot of work with industry partners. So, for example, this you can see here three-dimensional geomechanical model of the Kibini apatite deposit, which is one of the largest deposits of apatite in the world. After their establishing geological institute, it was soon realized that we need a special research unit which has to deal with the chemical technologies of extraction of useful components from the raw materials which we mine in Kola. And this is how the Institute of Chemistry and Technology of Rare Elements and Mineral Raw Materials was established in 1957. And so they elaborate chemical technologies for mineral processing for rare and rare earth metals from the Kola raw materials. They do also construction materials for the Arctic. And here you can see, for example, this is do some other interesting stuff. For example, here you can see the pigment powders on the right side. On the left side, you can see pigment powders. So this is real, real colors. So this is not computer colors. And they also grow some lithium niobate crystals for the application for the laser optic applications. The Institute of North Industrial Ecology Problems dealing with different environmental problems and On protection of vulnerable Arctic ecosystems and changing climate and environmental conditions. And two of my colleagues will speak about this a little bit later. And they also do Arctic biodiversity and biological collections, and also maintain some observation networks in the Arctic nature resource in the Russian north. So, for example, they compiled this red data book of the Murmansk region of the endangered, of rare and endangered species of the Kola Peninsula. We have an institute for economic studies, which mostly deals with Arctic economy, energy resources, Northern Sea Route, some Arctic mineral resources and their rational exploration. This institute published two journals, one in English. It's called Barents Studies, People, Economies, and Politics. It's published in collaboration with the University of Lapland and the University of Tromsø. And they also published one journal in Russian. It's called North and Market. This is about social and economical problems of the North and the Arctic. Especially for the Russian side. Recently, we have established small but very, this is kind of network center for the nanomaterials research center, which is kind of multidisciplinary center, which develops new materials and new nanomaterials, new nanotechnologies, based on the nature of the knowledge which we gain from nature, from minerals. So this is one of the mottos. It is minerals as advanced materials. And for example, this one of the recent results for this is elaboration of new nanomaterials for the safe treatment of liquid radioactive waste in the Russian Arctic zone. And you know, this is a big problem for us Russians. And we have elaborated some one very effective material which can handle very efficiently radioactive liquid waste. We have some smaller divisions like Institute for Informatics and Mathematical Modeling, which is dealing with the modeling of natural, technological, and social problems in the Russian Arctic. We have also Northern Energetic Research Center, dealing mostly with energy issues in the Kola Peninsula. And very recently, we have established Research Center for Human Adaptation in the Arctic, which is a center, the purpose of which is to study adaptation mechanisms of the health of settled and incoming population to the climate and environmental conditions of the Arctic zone. Very interesting center, Barents Center of the Humanities, which deals with history and culture of the Barents and the Euro-Arctic region, of the adaptation of indigenous and Russian population to the changing economical conditions. They also do ethnoeconomics, and they also they maintain small but very rich in artifacts and documents museum of the history of the study and mastering of the European North. And we have several institutes of Russian Academy of Sciences in the Kola Peninsula, which are not directly the parts of our Kola Science Center, but they are rather affiliates. So this one of these is Murmansk Marine Biological Institute, quite famous institute on marine biology, and they do a lot of studies on marine biological marine ecosystems and shelf, and also chemical radioactive contamination of the environment. We also have the world's oldest polar alpine botanical garden institute, which now has also the status of institute, and it deals with Arctic biodiversity. So they have biological collections, in and outdoor biological collections, and they also maintain museum. This is a really interesting place to go to visit. Finally, we have two geophysical institutes. This is a Polar Geophysical Institute and Kola branch of the Russian Academy of Sciences Geophysical Survey, and they do a lot of geophysical observation in the Arctic. They have research bases on Svalbard archipelago, and they also participate. They study cosmic rays, solar terrestrial relations, and they also participate in international research networks. So you can see that the Russian Academy of Science Institutes in the Arctic, so which are located above the Arctic Circle, deal with a broad range of topics, of scientific topics, starting from geology and geophysics and to history and culture. And what we want for the future, what we need for the future. And you, maybe you know that our president launched in May this year, he launched several national projects, one of which is a national project called Science, and it includes such events as renovation of research infrastructure, increasing cooperation with industry, cooperation with universities in order to grow the new generation of scientists for the Arctic. And we are also very much oriented towards international cooperation, and this is why we are here. With this, I thank you very much for your attention.